Maybe for the girls, you might be curious if kamu buat semua ini, does it really affect your girls? For me, yes. 100% affect my girls. Hey guys, what is up? Thank you so much for clicking into this video. If kamu orang baru sini, then please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you're new to me, you're not really sure like what is the vocabulary loss, then go to my first part of the video where I talk about how I lost 11 kg and how I got myself into this 4 kg extra. Alright, so pause this video and watch that video first. But yang sudah lihat video itu, this is going to be me talking about how I lose my belly fat. Sebelum tadi start, aku kan bagi kamu a brief about the timeline of everything yang aku buat selama 2017. So from January to August, I did sign up for a gym, and the gym yang aku sign up for is gym from KL. Sana aku spend about 129 ringgit Malaysia lah per month. That includes unlimited access to the gym, to the fitness classes, any types of classes aku boleh join unlimited. Asal tahan saja. And then from September to October, aku balik semula ke Brunei because within that period, that was my short semester. But then the subject yang I'm supposed to take for that semester, cikgunya dah dah. So I have to defer by one semester, so I have to go back to Brunei. Berapa juga kan dah batal di KL, dia jodohkan apa-apa. Instead of going to the gym, aku jog instead and hiking like usual. Somewhere in October, aku fucked up my spine. Aku kena tahan diri pas. I think seminggu lebih kali aku kena tahan. So basically, macam any spine go, the spinal disc surung keluar. After that, November to December, aku balik semula ke KL because I'm supposed to do my research project. Time November tu, aku punya supervisor ada advice aku yang semua lab material ready sudah. So I flew back to KL and do my research sana. But at the same time, since research ku ni, it involves a lot of waiting time. So while waiting in between, aku ke gym join. And I also do street workout. So that's the timeline for this video. Mostly we're going to be talking about January sampai August, the period where aku training dalam gym. Alright, remember in part 1 aku cakap pasal McDonald's, it's like 5 minute walk saja dari tempat ku tinggal. Well, the gym is even closer. Gym itu bangunan sebelah McDonald's, which is about 3 to 4 minutes walk dari tempat ku tinggal. Jalan kaki dari rumah ke sana, it's already like a warm up session. First month time January itu, I don't really see any results, so I was quite disappointed with myself. Masa itu aku belum control makanku until I met this personal trainer kindly enough to train me within that 2 weeks period for free. Yeah, ada sukat aku dah jual. I don't have the paper now. Aku buang sudah shit. I should have kept the paper. But that automatic machine, you just need to stand there and it will scan every part of your body. Lepas itu, ada kena print this receipt. It tells you semua calculation kamu punya body weight lah. Your muscle mass, your fat percentage, the mass of your bones. Fat percentage ku was about 24 point something. Cincah-cincah 25 lah ha. Masa tu, I was given up sudah wah. Pasal sebulan itu aku workout, no result. Yelah, pikir tu, train aku. Awal-awal dia tanya lah, what was my biggest concern? I told him I don't have that nice rounded shoulder one. For me to get that, he told me that I have to work extra hard to build the muscle sini because he said something about aku punya muscle di belakang ni kan. It was never fully utilized, that's why you stayed on it. If that makes sense, I don't even know. Another concern is also my lower belly. I told him I lost the best kg itu, but then parut ku masih lander on. But we ended up buat a lot of shoulder workout instead of parut. Masalah masa tu, ya offer aku for free, just only choose one body part. So that's why ya train aku on shoulder saja. So abs, I trained it myself. He introduced me to this rope exercises. Lain rasanya main rope tu, but after a while, I managed to get into it. Boleh lah. Awal-awal tu memang payah pulang. And then after that, okay lah. But that's not the main point here. The main thing yang aku wanted to talk about is the abs. Aku train abs satu for the whole month of January sampai August satu. Actually, up until now pulang. I do abs every day. In May, kalau kamu ada follow aku arah Instagram, rambutku start bertakar. That's when I started yoga. At first, I thought macam boring kan yoga ni. It's all about like breathing apa, and then stretches, sit down, downward dog, and then, you know, you've seen people do yoga, right? When I got involved with it, like, damn, it's fucking hard. It ain't that easy. Before I check up, I don't have any problem with people who build muscle just for show. That's good, you do you, keep going. But for me, I prefer having a functional muscle. By doing yoga, I noticed how dysfunction my abs were. Masa May ato, I could say my ab workout was on point sudah. But I noticed it was like useless. The yoga movement that I did, payah aku kan buat. Yeah, I know it's all about balancing and stuff, but it's also about controlling your muscle apa. So if you don't condition your muscle properly, if your muscle doesn't have a very good endurance, you're gonna have that wobbly shake form when you do yoga. Also, I noticed when aku start yoga, aku punya cellulite, especially arah tepat paha aku, it's starting to get decreased. In July, I met this calisthenic guys. He introduced me to arah grupnya, dorang group calisthenics lah. These guys are from my uni juga, and some of them are not from my uni, just from outside uni, and we're gonna talk about that later. But basically, that's when I got involved with calisthenics, but not fully, but just like, you know, introduction to calisthenics. And then, August, aku quit gym, simply because that was during my final exam season, so I couldn't make up time to go to the gym. Dan tentulah schedule aku, like bagi aku membazir gitu, aku bayar bulan-bulan tapi jarang ke gym kan. Oh yeah, dalam seminggu itu I go to the gym every day except Sunday. Masa August itu I could only go for one or two days saja, aku membazir gitu kan kalau aku bayar. So I quit gym and I just work out at a gym di uni ku, pasal the gym di uni itu it's free for students, so why not use it? That's how I met those guys. We're gonna break down to the abs workout that I did. From January to March, I did those 3 sets of 4 exercises, your typical ab workout punya schedule. Maksudnya 3 sets of 4 atau misalnya, okay, my favorite is leg raises, so that's one exercise. Another exercise of my favorite is also commando plank namanya, yang turun-turun itu. The third one is scissor legs, where kakiku just macam gunting turun-turun. The fourth exercise is for mountain climb. This is just an example of 4 different exercises. What it mean by sets is dalam satu exercise satu, misalnya leg raises satu, you have to do 3 different set. Dalam satu set itu you have reps. Maksudnya reps itu berapa kali kamu naikkan kamu punya kaki itu. Misal aku masa awal-awal I did 8, so 8 kali kamu naikkan kaki itu, it's considered 8 kali reps. If kamu complete sudah 8 kali reps naikkan kaki itu, that's considered one set. So you have to do 3 kali, so it's like 8 kali 3 total lah kamu. So 4 sets of 3, it's like the golden number for beginner. Aku start with 8 reps dulu lah, because come on, your girl is not that strong. I ain't got nothing for that. The reason why I choose different types of exercises for abs instead of just what sit up apa, I fucking hate sit up. I don't know, something about sit up macam ketir tuh rasanya. Have you guys ever felt that? Kalau mau like naik tim sit up atau cuma kan berjalan rasanya. That's why aku alternated with other types of exercises. Pasal exercises ini, don't just simply follow what I'm doing lah. My back to curve ke belakang, so it's really hard for me to control without hurting my back. That's the reason why I choose other alternative in terms of doing this ab workout. Week 1, I started off with 8 reps per set. Every week aku increase lah aku punya reps. As week progress, you're gonna get better. Don't just simply buat kalau kamu rasa ada sakit lagi. You have to keep on increasing. The first week kamu buat mambang rasanya parut, and then the second week kamu buat nggak lagi terasa, increase it. Biar rasa mambang. The more mambang it is, the better. That's how you know you're contracting your muscle to its fullest potential. Just keep on increasing if kamu rasa nggak terasa lagi. Apa kan? Awas. Catulah. Week 1, I started with 8. Week 2, naik ke 10. Week 3, naik ke 12. And then week 4, 15. Week 5, week 6, week 7, week 8. So naik from 15 to 18 to 20 to 22 to finally 25. I managed to do that within January to March. And then I could notice the more I increase my reps, the first few 15s belum ada terasa. So I'm starting to get concerned with myself. Rasa mambang itu nak tahu. So I reach out around my social media lah. Then ada orang inbox aku. They say I have to like change my workout style. And he gave me example lah, tambah medicine ball kah, pakai yoga ball kah, pakai dumbbell kah. So I ended up choosing yoga ball. The type of workout yang aku buat is, okay, let me show you, ada this video clip aku buat where aku pegang bulat tu and passing ke kakiku and then constantly doing that lah. The first week aku start that yoga ball, damn, I could only stay up to 15 reps saja. Slowly it's increasing from 15 to 20, from 20 to 25, and finally 30. So every week lah aku increase. That's when I noticed it started to feel that lagi. Wow, aku macam buri kenapa yang ada rasa tu lagi. And then I read around internet, it says something about your muscle is kind of like used to your workout, that you won't be able to feel it. So that means if you're not gonna change up your workout, your result is just gonna stay that way. That's why I keep on challenging myself. So I came up with this stupid challenge that I made by myself, which I called as 5-minute plank challenge. I started working out on this challenge start dari bulan 4 itulah. Let me show you in this video. Within that 5 minutes ato, you have to keep on planking non-stop. The first minute kamu buat the Superman plank, instead of your usual plank pakai elbow ato, this one you use your palm pegang ara lantai, stay there for 1 minute, and then after 1 minute habis, the second minute this time go down to your elbow, your usual plank position. After that 1 minute pass, do a side plank sebelah kiri 30 seconds, sebelah kanan 30 seconds, and then change it up lagi. The fourth minute you go back to your usual frontal plank, but this time naikkan satu kaki. Misal kaki kanan kamu naikkan, so tahan for 30 seconds, then sampai lagi sebelah kiri, tahan that position for 30 seconds. And the final minutes back semula arah Superman plank 30 seconds, and then go back down your final one, the frontal plank, for 30 seconds. You have to do this exercises sepanjang 5 minit non-stop. The first time aku cuba, I could only stay up until 2 minutes setengah. Gila, sakit dong perutku. Eventually I managed to stay up sampai 5 minit. The video yang aku liatkan kamu ini, I know my form looks piut bimbang, but this was the first time aku managed to hold sepanjang 5 minit itu. I was surprised with myself, like, oh my god, girl, you can hold this 5 minutes plank, then you can do anything. So I have that 3 sets of 4 exercises. Sometimes I make it 5 to 6 if I feel like I'm tired. And then I have that yoga ball dua. Finally go straight to the 5 minute plank. Let's just say it's like a burnout session. I will go to my maximum effort lah. Another thing that also assists me in buang lemak di bawah itu is also pemakananku. After aku jumpa PT itu, he really encourages me to go for diet. That's when I got into paleo diet. Paleo diet, if you have heard, people would say avoid carbohydrates. I'm just gonna address carbohydrate as carbs lah. Dalam paleo diet ini, the most important rule is you have to avoid makanan berproses. Misalnya yang dalam tin itu, sardine dalam tin kah, corned beef kah, chicken ham kah. Try to avoid that as much as you could. I know masa ni banyak sudah makanan proses, macam kerupuk udang apa tu. Try to avoid that. Kalau kamu kan makan pun, try to make something out of your own organically, bukan yang berproses bercampur dengan other chemicals, other preservatives. And also, you have to avoid dairy products. Contohnya macam cheese, yogurt, but milk. Kadang aku cover lah which milk I actually drink. I still drink milk. This two thing is very important. No sugar and salt. You have to remember that. Kalau misalnya you have a sweet cravings, kamu mudah crave untuk something manis, you can switch it up dari gula to buah-buahan. Kalau kamu biasa makan masin macam aku solve this problem by switching it up to herb and spices. The herb yang aku selalu pakai is basil, oregano, black pepper. Sometimes I would throw lemon pepper juga, and then parsley. Ini aku beritahu kamu what to avoid kan for paleo diet. Apa tak dimakan tu? So okay, mostly kamu mesti makan vegetables, protein and healthy fats. Dalam piring kamu tu, make sure dalam 2/3 tu kamu makan sayur-sayuran. Selebihnya 1/3 tu protein sama healthy fats and also buah-buahan. For protein, I come up with 3 different varieties lah. 1 chicken breast, 2 daging, apa saja jenis daging. I don't even know how to choose daging. Thirdly, salmon. Aku mostly makan salmon sama ayam lah, either 2 ni. Pasal 2 ni yang paling senang dan dapat. Kalau daging tu mahal sikit. But if misalnya liur aku berubah macam I got bored this and I will eat meat. Make sure kamu ada at least 3 different sources of protein just so that kamu in the boring makan the same thing every day. My source of fats is either avocado, pisang ataupun kacang almond. Fruits still avocado, banana, and any types of berries macam strawberry ka, blueberry ka, raspberry ka. For sayur-sayuran, try to have a variety of sayur yang kamu temakan. Because I know ada orang payah makan sayur. Try to have different types of sayur just so that kamu in the long will makan the same sayur over and over again. Sometimes kalau kamu makan the same sayur every day, rasanya tu boleh membuat kamu kan mual. Sayur aku makan mostly spinach. Spinach is bayam. And then green beans macam kacang panjang ataupun kacang buncis. Aku mostly makan lettuce lah, pasal lettuce murah. Sometimes I switch up to pumpkin ataupun broccoli ataupun capsicum. Capsicum itu aku only makan yang merah sama hijau pulang saja. Then celery helps me a lot, especially kalau tema aku menses. Kan kalau aku menses payah sikit kan workout, especially for those girls yang ada senggugut. I'm sure you know what I mean. Kalau kan workout itu gila, tak tahan bah, macam sakit bah. Celery is very good in burning calories even when you're not doing anything. Aku selalu blend and minum airnya setiap malam, kadang-kadang pagi juga. So setiap malam sebelum tidur, I still keep that for our window, nak makan apa-apa sebelum tidur. Pagi, itu yang first aku minum juga. Kan pagi-pagi kadangnya bloated kan, temenses. Celery helps me to flatten that surface. So those are the 4 main things in paleo diet. Protein, vegetables, fruits, and then your healthy fats. Okay? Ingatkan siapa petani. But then, ada orang bertanya, what about kamu punya source of carbohydratesnya? What about kamu punya source of fiber and then calcium apa? Carbs and fiber, you can get semuanya dari sayur. Contoh macam broccoli, capsicum, bayam. They are one of a few good source for carbs juga. Aside from that, buah-buahan avocado. Avocado have a very good carbs juga. Carrot has a very good fiber. Raspberry ada fiber juga dalamnya. For calcium, we have to avoid anything with dairy kan. To switch it up, you can try drinking soya milk ataupun almond milk. I think that is all to cover pasal pemakanan. For the results, I managed to flatten my stomach. But indah semua. Lemak itu masih ada sana. It's really, really hard to target arah lower belly itu especially. That's why I love leg raises because it targets mainly arah bawah itu. Aside from that, my cellulite pun hilang. Aku ada gambarnya sebenarnya, but I don't think it's appropriate to show here because satu gambar juburku. So I have major cellulite dan jubur sampai ke paha. Masa aku lost 12 kg itu, I managed to remove cellulite di jubur, tapi yang di paha masih ada. After I did my workout dari January sampai August itu, I managed to remove the cellulite arah paha aku juga. Aside from that, paha aku pun makin damage juga. It's because of the Zumba class yang aku join because the instructor is like, she kill me. Pernah masa itu aku hair datang, baik kena benda push up. Even though aku datang awal, I would try to book a slot di ba kang scan. She would drag me to the front seating niya. Kilala, yeah, mostly target ara Pahala. I would give this credit to her because without her, I don't think Pahala will have any changes. She sort of helped me to slim down the key to join. Okay, also cup size. Maybe for the girls, you might be curious if kamu buat semua ni, does it really affect your girls? For me, yes. 100% affect my girls. Before my weight loss, my size has always been 38B. After that weight loss, my size has gone down to 36B. But after a full control of makanan ko and then go to the gym, my cup size have changed from 36 to 32B. Can you imagine how far that is? Pasal the paleo diet, I mostly avoid carbs ba. After I stopped doing paleo, I'm still doing paleo now, but not fully lah, macam half-half lah. But I try not to skip carbs too much. And ever since I incorporated back carbs into my life, I managed to get my girls back. So now my cups has ranged between 34-36 lah. Especially time ko menses, it would reach up to be 36, but most of the time, it's 34B. Watch out girls, it's all up to you. Be careful with paleo diet because kamu na boleh cut off kamu punya diet completely. Masa aku buat paleo diet ini, I don't eat any nasi at all. And because of that, there's a slight depletion of my carbs. If you have depletion of carbs, that's gonna give another bad issue to you. And the next time you gain weight, you're gonna have hard time trying to remove the fat. Take note of that lah. If you need more information, you could just do your own research. As for my advice, work out not to get in shape, but work out trying to live a healthy lifestyle. It's very important to think of workout ani as a healthy lifestyle. You wanna go to fitness because you wanna get healthy. You can pasa kamu can get all this nicely shape papa. Because if ato mindset kamu, 5 years from now, I'm gonna guarantee you, you're gonna gain that weight back. Think of fitness as trying to make yourself feel better, trying to have a healthy life, okay? Because that happens to me as well. So like right now, this is where I'm at. I don't have any more defined abs papa. I'm just trying to focus on living healthy. So far, I'm happy with how I am right now. I think that is all for me guys. If ada misalnya still some of the parts I missed out and you guys are still curious, you can just simply comment di bawah and I will try to answer your questions. Stay safe and I hope to see you guys again in another video. Bye bye.